Hey everybody, welcome to the channel and welcome to beautiful, well, chilly Michigan. Got my sweatshirt on today. And in the background, you can see some of the leaves are changing already on the trees, which means, yep, winter is on its way. Now, as a prepping channel, I need to tell you, you need to be prepared for what's coming in the winter. We don't know what's gonna happen. We may have to bug out. You may become like a refugee. You may have to be out in the open elements. And obviously you need to have the clothing that's going to make it so you survive. Because it's not simply just putting on your coat and off you go. There's a lot more to winter survival than anything. Now, let's go ahead and look at the Nazis. During the Nazi time and the refugees, as they left, they didn't have like really expensive jackets and stuff. What they do? Layers. Layers and layers. They literally took all the clothes they had, as much as they could anyway, and just layered it on more and more and more. And that's still something we should do today, by the way. And I know we could go to the store and get a really nice heavy jacket, and that may seem like the logical choice, by the way. If you're just out in town, that is a logical choice. You can take it off and go in your store shopping and you'll be good. But not if you're talking about spending any time outdoors in the cold. Because what's going to happen is if you put that really heavy jacket on, it's gonna be warm, and then as you hike and as you backpack and as you bug out, whatever you need to do, you're gonna get sweaty underneath, and that's dangerous. I mean, as long as the jacket's on, it's not dangerous, but that jacket's gonna come off eventually. Not to mention when you basically sleep at night, unless you have a tent with you, you get in your sleeping bag, your inner clothes are gonna be soaked, and you're asking for, obviously, become sick. It's a very dangerous situation. So just like the refugees did back in Nazi Germany, you need to dress in layers. Nothing wrong with having a coat. And I'll show you some different coats in a little bit that you might want to consider getting, but you need to dress in layers. As you get colder, just put another layer on. You get colder, put another layer on. You hike some more, take a layer off if you're getting warm, and you basically balance yourself to do your best to not get sweaty. That's the key. Now, in addition, when it comes to sweatiness, when we look at cotton, when it comes to backpacking, by the way, there's a term we use called cotton kills. I like cotton shirts. They're nice and comfy, but they're not for hiking and backpacking and bugging out in winter gear, because the cotton will wick up all that sweat and make it exceedingly cold and stick to your body. You've probably had that happen before. So the first layer, as we'll look at a bunch of different things you need to dress as, the first layer we'll look at is having an inner layer, and that's some kind of dry fit. Dry fit shirts are pretty amazing, and obviously I use these for working out too, but they do very well at keeping that water off of you, and it evaporates the water very quickly. If you don't have a dry fit, which I recommend you get one, I'll put a link below for these items if you do want to get them, then you're at least going to have to look at getting some kind of wool. Wool's been around, well, ever since sheep were invented. But we want to look at domesticated wool. It's actually called merino wool, and it's much softer and not as itchy as the wool that, you know, we used to be what we're used to. You know, like in the military, we had wool blankets. It was not merino wool, very itchy blankets, but you didn't really sleep in your skivvies anyway and get all itchy from that blanket. But you know what? It worked amazingly well on not absorbing the water and keeping nice and warm. A nice merino wool head cap. I love this hat, by the way. I have a whole bunch of different types of beanies and hats, but this one over the years has become my favorite. It's nice and thin, it's not itchy, but since it actually has the wool material we're looking at, it keeps my head nice and warm. And of course, we know a lot of heat is lost through your head. Not as much as they used to say, by the way. It was something like, what, 50%, 70% of your heat was lost through your head. Now there is a lot, by the way. If you're dressed warm, you're gonna lose a lot through your head, but having obviously a wool cap is good. This actually came with some wool gloves that actually match it. And these are comfortable too. But I find when it comes to these gloves, they, you know, honestly, they do absorb a lot of water. They retain a lot of water, how about that? So they're not the warmest of gloves. Something else you might want to consider too is getting a face shield. These face shields, they look really awkward, maybe you're about to rob a bank, but they work well as far as this being neoprene, keeping your face warm too. I'll tell you, you've been those days before where it's so cold out and all the wind and everything whips at your face and you feel like your face has ice crystals. Having one of these in your bag for bugging out would be something that's very advantageous and make you feel a lot warmer as you go. Instead of the wool gloves, you may want to consider getting some tactical gloves made of neoprene. They have a lot of rough areas for the palms so you can grab things. And even more so, they have knuckle guards on them. That's what they call them, by the way, your knuckle guards. But they're not there to bang your knuckles. They're there so in case you need to punch something. Again, I'll put a link below for these. But I use these all the time, especially when I go hunting and it's really cold. They're amazing gloves to be able to feel what you need to and actually have that extra protection layer as well. Well, protecting you anyway. And something else we're looking at, by the way, being wool, are wool socks. I'll tell you, I bought a pair of these, and I loved them. I bought so many of them. They are incredibly warm, incredibly comfy, and in the wintertime, I use these extensively. And I even say this too, make sure in your bug out bag or whatever gear you have to leave, you don't have a pair of wool socks. You have multiple pair of wool socks. Keeping your feet warm is so essential. Obviously you can cause major problems, and if your feet are messed up, you're not walking anywhere and you're toast, you know what I'm saying? So have lots of wool socks with that. Now, having anything on the inside layer, either being the dry fit and wool, is obviously what you want, but the inner layer, you know, you have your skin, you have wool, and then you have the outer shell we'll look at in a minute, but the inner layer, probably having some fleece is a really good idea. If you have some kind of wool sweater, it'll work well too, but fleece is really nice because you can get multiple layers of it. It's actually really thin and will actually, and it will keep you very warm as you do your hiking or bugging out. Now, let's talk about that outer shell. Get away from the idea that you need a heavy jacket. Again, having a heavy jacket is good if you're doing some shopping or going around town, that's good, just kind of casual. But when it comes to survival, no, you want to have an outer shell. And notice these outer pants, they're waterproof, but the material being breathable is a good idea. And the jacket, this jacket actually, you know, being waterproof, has little slits on there, so it'll breathe. Breathing is the key, by the way. When we talked about, again, remember sweat, you want to make sure you don't sweat, which will make you very cold. Having a thick jacket is going to make you sweat more, and it's something you can't take off. You know, hiking without the jacket on in the snow and wind and everything is obviously going to be problematic. And that takes us to boots. Obviously something you want to have in your gear. First off, you must find a boot that is comfortable for you. Having the right foot size is so essential. And something you have to take into account too, that if you're gonna be hiking winter and hiking in snow, you're gonna be having the wool socks on, and trying the boot on with regular socks is not a good idea. You wanna have it fit very well to what your foot is like with those wool socks on. Something else too, insulation, have a little bit of thick there. These boots actually have a thermal layer to keep your feet warm. You wanna make sure they're waterproof. It literally makes it so the water drains off of it, so it doesn't, you know, the sweatiness of your feet will dissipate. Also, when you look at the boot, you wanna make sure you have a good sole on there. The harder the sole is to bend, the better it is for backpacking, because as you walk on rocks and everything, you wanna make sure it doesn't pierce into your foot. But that's all the things you wanna look for. You wanna make sure that it has everything you need. And honestly, when it comes to the boots, that's probably, in my opinion, one of the most important things you get is get a really good boot. Now, some people like to get the steel toe ones. And obviously if you're working or even cutting logs, steel toe is a good idea. I personally am not a big steel toe person, although I've had a lot of steel toe boots in the past. I'm just really careful I don't drop logs on my feet, the best I can anyway. But that's just me, my own personal opinion on that. So make sure you have a really good pair of boots. These Columbias, I'll put a link below for this too, but you wanna make sure again you get one that fits your foot very well. Okay, one more option you wanna think about is, on top of all that, you may be bugging out into a place out in the wilderness, in the woods, where you're gonna be doing a lot of work like cutting and stuff. And again, that's where the steel-toed boots would come in handy. But something else you need to think about too is having very, very rugged clothes. Right now I just have a sweatshirt on. This thing's not gonna fare up too well by cutting wood and living out in the wilderness for any extended period of time. And I would say you would need to get what are called Carhartts. I use the air quotes, I don't buy Carhartts. I actually have a pair of Carhartt bibs I got at a thrift store for next to nothing. But most of our work gear, or basically our Carhartt knockoffs, last just as long. We use a company called Blue Mountain. I have a set, my wife Ashley has a set, my son Sam has a set. They have held up for years and years, in my opinion, just as durable as the Carhartts, and have lasted just as long at half the price. They're amazing. But having a set of that, maybe even just the complete overalls, you know, the coveralls, I should say, would work really well in keeping you warm and being durable. I'm amazed, even on the coldest winter's days here in Michigan, where it's well below zero, I'll go out with those Carhartts on and it's like no problem at all. Granted, my face gets cold without a face shield, or sometimes we'll have like a really big heavy hat on in those cases. My wool cap is really nice, but having those Carhartt knockoffs work really well. I'll put a link for those in below if you want to check out some of those different Carhartt knockoffs to get as well. I mean, if you want to get Carhartts, go for it, but you can pay twice as much. All right, so that's what you're looking at. If I were you and you have a bug out bag, or a bag for your car in case you need to evacuate. It's not simply just like I'm leaving my home for no reason. You may have to leave. There may be a wildfire, there may be an earthquake, there may be something that takes your house out. you have to be able to be prepared to bug out. And having all the stuff, even if you simply put all the stuff into a very tight roll into your bag or your tub that you're going to bug out with, would be a really smart idea. Because, man, I couldn't even imagine bugging out in the middle of winter and having to survive out there, especially if you don't have the right gear. It's literally life or death. All right, thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.